It's a great song.
I like the Beatles.
Yeah, that's a great song. Great album, honestly.
Yeah. That was my first cassette tape I ever bought was the Beatles.
Yeah. Yeah, I have a friend. He's a good friend of mine. I met working at Starbucks, and he's got, you know, the Abbey Road tattoo, the Silhouette tattoo, and he loves it. He's got vinyls that are still sealed. You know,
I gave
him a 1,000-piece Beatles puzzle, and he's just like, I don't even want to open it because it looks so great.
Wow. You know?
He's a huge fan.
These kids carrying the signs are really enjoying that. Brandy is en route.
Oh. Let me know when to turn around.
Oh yeah, I will.
We got worried when we came up. There was a small ceremony for the people that were here before, and I just saw a bride in a dress. I was like, oh no.
Yeah, I know.
We're like, wait a minute.
It was just them.
Yeah.
You can probably turn right about now. Did you want to hand those flowers off? Did you want him right here, or do you want him on the side?
Yeah, here, buddy. Go over here next to Nathan.
You want to scoot this way a little bit for the photographer? There you go.
Yeah, 6 feet.
Well, Brandy and Cody, congratulations on all the little moments that have led to this final and culminating moment. Today you enter as individuals, but you leave here as husband and wife, blending your lives complete with Jameson and the family, and embarking upon the greatest adventure of your human life. The story of your marriage is still yours to write. Marriage is founded upon things like sincerity and trust and understanding and forgiveness. It involves respect for each other's feelings and weaknesses and faults. A happy marriage will enable you to establish a home with love and stability where your son Jameson will grow and develop and where family and friends will always be welcome and from which a base from which your influence of your shared life will happen. Every day you'll learn how to receive love with as much understanding as you give it. Find things within yourself that you can share them with each other. Do not fear this love. Have an open heart and sincere mind. Be sincerely interested in each other's happiness. Be constant and consistent in your love. From this comes security and strength. And all that we love deeply becomes a part of us on this day of your marriage. So commit yourselves fully and freely to each other. And I just remind you that you're celebrating the gift of love, and love is patient. Love is kind. Love is never jealous. Love keeps no record of wrongs. Now, generally we're scorekeepers, but not when it's when loving. Love takes no pleasure in other people's faults, but delights in the truth. It is always ready to excuse and to trust and to hope. It is always ready to endure whatever comes. True love does not come to an end. Love is the reason that together you'll become one in hope, one in believing in life, and one in sharing of the coming of years. So Brandy and Cody, just a few words of encouragement before you give your vows to each other. As a 26-year veteran of marriage, I will tell you that if you want to have a long, happy marriage, have a short memory.
I got you there already.
He's great at that.
Yeah. Okay,
very good. Keep that up. The other thing I will do is remind you that marriage is not so much about marrying the right partner or finding the soulmate. It is actually about becoming the right partner. It is a lifelong decision to every day wake up and become the right woman and the right man for each other. And to install buttons. I'm sure you've already installed buttons in each other, yes? So install the buttons that bring out the best in each other. And accept each other just as you are, as a gift. Just as you are, imperfect, but accept each other. Now, we come to the moment of vows, and you, my understanding is you've written your own vows.
We both have, yes.
That's very good.
Brandy, before we met, my life was in a whirlwind of insanity. Up was down, left was right, and diagonal was just far out. I couldn't even think of it. I was going in so many directions with no real goal. So when I first saw you, it barely registered, and I still don't remember it as clearly as you do.
Really?
Yep, I'll admit it today. However, I do remember your warmth to a person you didn't know, and it left an impression on me. The next time we met, we actually spoke to each other. Not in passing, you know, like, hi, or how are you doing, and here's your coffee, but we had an actual conversation. I was glad to make another genuine friend that I really, really needed. After that, I met Jameson. He was so shy and still is adorable. He likes to hide it though. Sorry guys. I was thrilled to learn his true nature as we warmed up to each other on our car ride, searching for your new apartment or getting the necessities for that apartment or looking at Christmas lights for the first year in Highland Park. Sorry. Also the time we took to learn about each other's past and where we want to go for our futures. I always found time in my day for our car rides. It came like a freight train when I first realized that I love you as more than a friend. Everything just calmed down when I was with you. You inspired and still do inspire growth. You fought so hard for your son and yourself. From exhausting days into restless nights working 3 jobs, you handled it all with angelic grace, resolute determination, and the occasional glass of wine. It's needed. How could I not fall
just
in love?
Fun,
yeah, just a really big glass. But how could I not fall in love with you? The biggest worry, which may well be one of our biggest strengths now, was how opposite we were. You were concrete. I was abstract. You're organized, I'm me, and you were growing while I was still scared to grow. There are many other examples, and they're all a part of what I feel makes us so strong now. Since then, the three of us have grown so well together physically, mentally, and emotionally, and truly come together as a family. Through laughter, tears, success, and failures, we always seem to come out on top with our love. So with that in mind and heart, I vow to always stand by your side, to continue in our mission of growth, to stand strong, stay faithful to you and our family, and be the best husband, father, and friend, no matter the trials we may face for eternity and long after. I love you.
Beautiful.
Thank you.
Mine's longer, I'm sorry.
Cody Lee Taylor.
Oh no, I'm in trouble.
The man who introduced me to all things good, like mushrooms, Brussels sprouts, baked goods from scratch. The man who taught me to love holidays, who fixes all of the technological things, and has been my favorite partner to adventure with for 4 years. I'd first like to share an excerpt I've come across that I find fitting for this day. It says, a soulmate connection isn't just an awareness. It's a deep sense of knowing, a wave of intuition that permeates your every pore. All the cells in your body rise up on their tiptoes. You don't see this feeling coming, you can't prepare for it, you might even try to push it away, and yet it always surges back, each time with a greater force, sweeping you up in its mighty current, thrusting you towards a beautiful shore unknown. Never did I think that saying hello to a complete stranger at 5 a.m. while working behind the bar would land me a husband, but if ever there was a time to believe in God, it is because of that fateful day. I came to Texas with a plan, a very clear plan that quickly unraveled beneath me, and when I finally came up for air, there you were. Neither of us considered it the perfect time, but you were continuously persistent, and each day I fell more for your charm a little more. I must say, though, that the invitation to come over on Christmas Day by bribing me with lots of good food that you needed help eating, and laughing with your mom after a few too many Christmas cocktails while attempting to understand how to operate her new food saver might have been the thing that sold it for me. I'm pretty sure I knew then that we'd be here today. We've done a lot of growing since then, both individually and as a couple. You've transitioned into an amazing and loving father, a hardworking provider, and an incredibly patient partner. You keep me balanced and grounded, pushing me hard and steadfast towards my goals, but supporting me the moment that I need to slow down. You are my rock, my calm in the chaos, my most profound ally, and simply put, my very best friend, who can magically draw a chuckle out of me, even on the darkest days. I've watched quietly as you've navigated the ins and outs of parenting, and have recently accepted that at times where I was once the teacher guiding you, the roles have fiercely reversed. Where I am short-tempered, you are kind and collected. When I am at my wit's end, you are resilient. When there are questions on history or science, necessary compromises to be made, or promises of fun and adventure, you are the go-to guy. I am so incredibly thankful for the love that is shared between you and Jameson. The choice that you made to love my son as boldly and immensely as you do is a tremendous act of devotion and honor that warms my heart and invigorates my soul each day. Today, I vow to awaken every single day with the gratitude for the strength and resiliency that we both have been graced with in the past, while together and while apart. I vow to end every evening praying for that same strength and resiliency for our future. I promise to love you wholeheartedly for the rest of my life, even when I don't really like you, because we argue about whose turn it is for the dishes or taking the dogs out, or more than likely you folded the towels wrong again. I promise to always be honest with you, even when it is difficult, and to choose you in every lifetime. Lastly, I vow that in the turbulent times which are bound to pronounce themselves in the years to come, I will hold tightly to you, matching your persistence from the beginning. In those defining moments, I will cling to that soulmate connection, that deep sense of knowing, the wave of intuition that permeates my every pore. And I will stand up, ready to take on a new day on a beautiful shore unknown, with my hand in yours. I am so excited for what our future holds, even if that means suffering through your corny dad jokes and puns for forever. I love you, and I cannot wait to meet you.
Amen. Beautiful vows. I would just encourage you next year on this date, and 5 years on this date, and 10 years, take those out and read them to each other again, just as a reminder of this special moment and your own words to each other. So with that, may the rings please. The rings, rings.
Here's a, wait.
Oh, you're getting the ring, huh?
These rings, we pray, will be a blessed symbol of your affectionate union. Your two lives will now be joined together in one unbroken circle. And wherever they go, may they always return to each other in togetherness. And may the home that you establish be a place of sanctuary that many will find a friend. And may these rings on your fingers symbolize the touch of spirit of love in your hearts. So that takes that. I'll place it on Brandy's ring finger. This one. And repeat after me. Brandy with this ring.
Brandy with this ring.
I give you the promise.
I give you the promise.
That from this day forward.
I'm sorry?
That from this day forward.
That from this day forward.
You shall never walk alone.
You shall never walk alone.
My heart will be your shelter.
My heart will be your shelter.
My arms will be your home.
My arms will be your home.
We'll walk together through life.
We'll walk together through life.
As partners. As partners.
As partners.
And best friends.
And best friends.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
Take that and place that on Cody's ring finger. Yes, that's the right one. All right. If you repeat after me. Cody with this ring.
Cody with this ring.
I give you the promise.
I give you this promise.
That from this day forward.
That from this day forward.
You shall never walk alone.
You shall never walk alone.
My heart will be your shelter.
My heart will be your shelter.
My arms will be your home.
My arms will be your home.
We'll walk together through life.
We'll walk together through life.
As partners and best friends.
As partners and best friends.
I give you my heart.
I give you my heart.
Now may you receive this blessing. Now you'll feel no storms. For each of you will be the shelter to the other. Now you'll feel no cold, for each of you will be the warmth to the other. Now there is no loneliness, for each of you is the companion to the other. You are two persons, but there's one life before you and one home. May happiness be your companion, may beauty surround you in your journey ahead and through all your years to come. And may your days be good along upon this earth. Your adventure of marriage has just begun. Brandy and Cody, today you have chosen before everyone to begin your life together, complete with your son, Jameson. For all the tomorrows that follow, you'll choose each other over and over again in the privacy of your hearts. Let your love and friendship guide you as you learn and grow together. Experience the wonders of the world, even as patience and wisdom calm the restless nature. Through your partnership, may you always triumph over the challenges in your path. And through the comfort of your loving arms, may you always find a safe place to call home. And may you love each other so much that when people see you together, they say, God's a good God to put these two together. We have all been a witness today and all invited to this very special occasion. And you have sealed your love with vows and exchanged two rings as a sign and symbol to the world that you are indeed married. So by the authority given to me by the state of Texas and by God above, I announce that you are indeed now bona fide. No running. You're legal eagle. You are married. At this time, Cody may kiss your bride once or 30 times. Okay. And now Jameson is going to make a special announcement. Let me get the mic for you. Okay, go ahead and say it.
Now presenting Mama and Cody Table.